it's clear. Now we will just already drag this one here, but before that I forgot to put here that total. Now I will put design text box here. So this is order total. Left, then white, so that the same width. TXT total. Okay, here sum, then init amount. Init amount. Now I will drag this one here. Then we need to link this one for this order number. Just click this one, then order number. Okay, it's fine. Look, I can choose this one, then I will put quantity 10. Automatically the net amount will calculate, and here also, look, here also will update. You see water, I will choose 15, then 35, noodles I will put 10. It's coming dollar, I will modify that one. Format, make it standard. Okay, so now we have order line, so I will make this one is completed. Then we'll create another. Then water, say 15, then noodles, say 10. Okay, if I will close this one, there's no error. Why? Because this particular purchase order line is linked with our purchase order number. So presuming that this one is already sent to the supplier, so we expect the item will arrive. So we need to put some form also that can handle
to receive that particular item line and will update our existing inventory. So here we will just only create a PO for this particular items to our supplier. This is the one we order, and now we will create another form to manage to receive that particular items by order number. Okay,
first we will copy this one, order line, just copy and paste, and we will put this one inbound item line. And this one, we will receive the items based on the PO, but we will not modify the entries here. We will just only receive the quantity from our supplier based on the order quantity. Okay, so here we need to remove this one, but before that I need to add here this description, because why? If I convert to text box, it will show the item code. Look, that's why I need to use this one. So that whatever our order line from our purchase order, the same line for our inbound items. So here we need to remove this one. Order quantity will keep as is, amount also we need to remove this one. Unit price, we will keep as is that one. Then here we need to add in and out quantity here. This is the ordered quantity. Unit price, then quantity. I will not put quantity in, quantity out, because this transaction we will base on our line status here and notes. We will make it wider. So, to avoid any modification from this item, ordered item and quantity, and of course unit price, we need to make it lock. First, I will make it enable no, then lock yes, so that no one can modify this one, only this quantity. Again, this quantity of transaction we will base on this one. If I will select this receive also, it will add into our inventory. This confirm is just only to confirm that we received but not yet entered or putting in our inventory. That's why it's only confirmed. And you can put any notes here based on this entries. Okay, now
we will put some code to execute whatever the quantity that we will input here. It will update also our inventory. So straightforward, we will use, you know, before this one, stack in and stack out. So we will only use this code here. So if we will select receive, so we will choose this code here. So this is the one. But here again, after update this one line status, so this is in and out quantity. After update, we will use if statement here. Line status. If may dot line status dot value equal receive, then we will execute this one, our inventory quantity, and here our in out quantity. So whatever we put in out quantity, it will add our existing inventory, so it will update. Then we put end F. So we just copy again this one. So instead of plus, we'll put here minus. So meaning the existing inventory deducted whatever returned quantity. So returned. We'll make sure the, we'll try to make sure if line status is correct, returned, okay, correct. So this is the one. If our status is received, whatever we enter in out, then automatically it will add our existing inventory. So if we will select return also, automatically it will deduct from existing inventory. And with should be here, I forgot to put NF. Okay, now I will close this one. Order line, I will close. Again, I will copy this one, purchase order. I will put ordered inbound. Inbound ordered items. Item. Okay. Then just press F2, our inbound line, just to copy this one. Then here, inbound ordered item, here we will modify the source object. Okay, now I will adjust. This is just only an example, so it's your discretion to what's really the transaction or the activity based on your company. So I just make it all lock.
And here also, make it black. Because the only transaction here is here, based on this particular purchase order. Okay, now we will execute this one. See, we'll start with PO 9, this one, 549. Okay, now this is our inventory. I just want to show you that whatever we enter here, automatically it will update. This is milk, so I will put 50. Then receive. If I close this one, automatically it will update to 50 inventory. Again, this one is noodles. Here I will put 15 because this is our 10. This is our order quantity is 10, so we receive 10. Look, there's no existing inventory. If I select receive, then I will close this one, automatically it will update. Here, water, we have existing inventory 25, so we have 15 PO. Then I will select receive. If I will close, automatically it will update. Now, let's see. We will return this particular PO. We will return, let's say 5. We'll put 5 here. Look, milk 50. We will return 5. So automatically it will deduct our inventory. Select return. Actually, this is not the actual activity to update our inventory, but this is just only to show you how this process using this form to update the existing inventory. So I will return this one 5. Then if I will close, lock, it will deduct. Again, if I return here water, I will return 5 also. Then this one will make it 50. Lock. So we need to make a report, so every time we have PO, we can view and we can print or export to PDF. Thank you and God bless.